Hello everyone. Welcome to this mentoring session, Selenium with Java, Introduction to Automation. So we will see what are the three rules that we need to follow when we are going to automate anything. Okay, so this is what I learned from one of the trainers when I was in one of the class. Okay, so and that person was teaching about what are the rules to be followed when you're going for any automation. Okay, so he said something like this. He said, whenever you are going to automate something, okay, so that should save time and resources. Okay, so that means, so whenever we are planning to automate something, we have to see the final output as in it should be saving time and resources. If not, if it is not saving time and resources, then don't automate it. Let it be manual process. Okay, so always see the end result, whether it is going to save time or not. And secondly, it should be, your automation should be run in unattended mode. That means you should not be in front of your machine to check whether automation is properly running or not. You should have 100% confidence on your automation that it will run smoothly, and your automation should be in such a way that you could run at any time in any machine. Okay, so you can schedule it rather, you know, instead of checking manually, checking whether it is performing steps as per your automation scripts. So you are going to schedule it, and you know, ideally it is run at night time or in the weekends it is run. So that is how your ideal automation should be. And thirdly, whatever you are automating, run in the future. Okay, so these are the three simple rules. So basically what that means is, don't automate something just for today. Okay, so before you script anything, have a futuristic scope in mind that you want to have minimum maintenance and, you know, maximum run usage, so it is runnable in the future. Okay, so these are the three rules for the automation. Now going to Selenium. Okay, so we'll start with introduction to Selenium and tool installation. So now first let us start with Selenium components. So you might have already heard about this, but it may be a refresher. Okay, so let me start here. Okay, yeah, so in 2004, Jason Huggins, you might have heard this name, at ThoughtWorks, he was testing some things repeatedly, and he wanted to be smart enough so that it would save his time. He developed something using JavaScript, okay, and that became the core component for Selenium RC. Okay, okay, so this is the older part of Selenium. We can call this as Selenium 1.0. Okay, so similarly, so this was in 2004. Okay, so that person developed, and it was so interesting that, you know, JavaScript library was working fine, but the only limitation was it was using JavaScript component. So for some of the cases, for most of the browsers, right, JavaScript will not be allowed to run directly. So it was not. It was having that challenge. Okay, so how do you overcome that challenge? So that issue was there. Okay, and another challenge was web-based development was picking up. So there were new technologies that were coming up, like Dojo, Ajax, and things like that. So for those type of technologies, this Selenium RC was not capable of handling. Okay, so that these were the limitations. So let me just open the website of seleniumhq.org. Okay, so this is the main website for Selenium, which you can go for anything related to Selenium. This is the first website that you need to go through. Don't go for any other website which provide other information. This is the main website for us. So if you are checking something about or if you want to clarify something, if you have to get the clarification, come here first. So here there are some things that are given, okay, so which you can go through offline also. Okay, so we were discussing about Selenium 1.0, so which was in 2004. Similarly, in 2007, what happened? There was one more component developed by some other person called as Simon Stewart, okay, in 2007. And he that component was called as WebDriver. Okay, so this is just the history for us to know. Okay, so in one of the conference, okay, so they said that, okay, this component is there, this is having some capability, and this component is there, Selenium 1.0, that is Selenium RC. Okay, so these two components can be clubbed together and we can call it as Selenium 2.0. Okay, so this was a new version they have introduced called as Selenium 2.0. Okay, so now what is WebDriver? WebDriver is to control your web page. So there is a driver which, so basically through code you are going to have the driver which is going to control the web page. Okay, so basically driver is going to control your web page, that is WebDriver. So there will be different drivers available, like if you have different browsers, for different browsers different drivers are available, like Firefox driver, for Firefox you have Firefox driver, for Google Chrome you have Google Chrome driver. So using driver, it is going to control the web page, and it is going to perform the action whatever you want to do on the web page. So Selenium is mainly created to automate any web-based applications. Okay, so that was the main purpose why it was created. And now why Selenium? So Selenium name appears to be like, you know, you might have heard about Selenium before when you were in college days. So Selenium is one of the element in the periodic table, just like mercury. Why Selenium name is that during 2000 period, okay, mercury was the predominant automation tool, like mercury, you might have heard of mercury quality center, mercury, this QTP, right? QTP was a tool that was owned by Mercury Corporation at that time, during that time. So Jason Huggins, you know, wanted a tool which is open source and, you know, having all the capabilities. Okay, so when it seems this was a joke, when he was mailing about the tool Selenium RC, okay, to other people, he was mentioning that Mercury is the one more element, right? So to cure mercury, we can use Selenium supplements. That is what he called, it seems. So hence the name Selenium. They thought we'll go for Selenium name going forward, and they have used the Selenium. Okay, so now we have discussed different components of Selenium. Okay, so you don't have to know about the older components. Okay, there are other older components, like in Selenium 1.0, there was one more component called as Selenium IDE, Integrated Development Environment. Selenium IDE is no longer, I mean, used in most of the projects. So this was coming from 1.0, so one of the older part of Selenium. So this is a plugin in Firefox. You can install this plugin, and you can use this plugin for record and playback, so to do some of the prototyping, to just see whether, you know, this Selenium IDE can record some of the code for you, and you can play it back. So that was the main reason why Selenium IDE was introduced, but it was not continued. They have stopped coding and things like that. So it is no longer in use. Okay. So that is about Selenium IDE. Again, Selenium Remote Control, RC stands for Remote Control. So this again is an older component that is no longer in use, so we don't have to know about Selenium RC. So in Selenium 2.0, we discussed about Selenium 2.0, right? In Selenium 2.0, in one of the conferences, Google conference, they discussed that, okay, there is a RC which was developed, which is existing, working very well. Similarly, the web driver also has been created by some other person. Okay, now why don't we integrate these two and have the very good capability? So that is why they have introduced 2.0, and it was having RC and RC things, remote control in web driver. Okay, so that capability was there. So that was in Selenium 2.0. Okay, and there is one more component called as Selenium Grid. So which was introduced, it was created by some other person. I don't know the name right now. So that person, what he said is, we can use Selenium Grid. So when we have requirement to do parallel testing, or when we want to run our tests in multiple instances, in different browsers, different machines, if we have such configurations, then we can go for Selenium Grid. Okay, so these are the things, these are the different components of Selenium. So now what all we need to know as part of Selenium? So we have to know WebDriver and we have to know Selenium Grid. Okay, so these are the two main components that we need to know, and we don't have to know other older components, okay, as part of our learning, because they are no longer in use. So now recently, they have introduced something called a Selenium 3.0. This was the one more major release from Selenium side. Now what changes they have introduced? Okay, so I'll quickly summarize about the changes. We are going to anyway discuss in detail about all these things, all this web driver and Selenium Grid components. Okay, so in Selenium 3.0, so they have kept it open source, everything. Okay, and so this part, right, Selenium RC component, they used to call it as Selenium Core. That was the core part of Selenium. And whoever were using the Selenium Core, in Selenium 2.0 also, they were supporting the Selenium RC users also, because in Selenium 2.0, Selenium RC component was also integrated, right, inside. So they were also supporting the customers at that time. But in Selenium 3.0, what they said is, we no longer want to have Selenium Core code. Selenium RC code, we no longer want to have. We want to delete it. So first change what they did is, they have removed all Selenium Core component. They have removed all the Selenium Core components. So you cannot use RC. So all the users who are using RC, they will be given the maintenance separately. Okay, so they don't have to upgrade to Selenium 3.0. That is what they said. Okay, so this is the first change, the major change they have introduced. And second major change they have introduced is, they have introduced something called as W3C. Okay, World Wide Web Consortium specification they have introduced for the browsers. Okay, so these are the two major changes from Selenium 3.0. And from functional part, what Selenium 3.0 offers, from functional part, Selenium 3.0 is offering many APIs related to mobile testing. Okay, so that is again from functional side they have introduced. Okay, now what are the browsers Selenium supports? What are the languages Selenium support? Selenium supports almost all the browsers which are available in the market that we use in our day-to-day basis or in any IT company. Like Internet Explorer, Firefox, Safari, Opera, major browsers it is supporting. And also it supports, let me just write them quickly. Okay, I'll say Internet Explorer, Firefox, Google Chrome. I am writing a short form. I hope you will understand. Google Chrome, then Safari, Opera. And then it supports, so these are the major browsers actually. Yeah, anyone wants to speak or something? I could hear some noise.
Yeah, actually I have joined recently, that's why you have recent hear the noise. Hi, this is Sumit.
Okay, no problem, yeah, sure. Okay, so fine, we were discussing about different, so these are the major browsers it supports. So Safari is from, other platform, not Windows, right? So Opera, Google Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, all these are the Windows platform. Okay, so Safari is from Mac platform, and it also supports Android and iOS. So when I say like this, that means it is for mobile platforms. So Selenium can be used for mobile platforms also, but it is with different name. They call it as APM, you might have heard of. So they call it with as APM, okay, but Selenium has the capabilities. Selenium 3.0 has capabilities to work with the Android and iOS platforms, okay? And also, there are other things it supports. So we'll discuss this in class. Like it supports HTML unit. It supports PhantomJS, okay? So these things we'll discuss in detail later on. Okay, so this is about what are the browsers it supports. Now, what are the languages it supports? So this is one of the, very rare tools which supports multiple languages, more than five. Okay, it supports languages like Java, Python, PHP, then JavaScript, Ruby, Perl, C sharp. Okay, so this is the list. So so what that means is whichever language you are comfortable with, it provides you the flexibility to code in automation. Okay, so unlike other automation tools like UFT or RFT, in which they say that you have to go for VB scripting or Java, okay? So VB scripting, I mean in UFT, and Java,